I'd like to present some do-in or self-massage, which is often used as a precursor to a Qigong form. During these times, and this video is made in April 2020, there's little or no touching, especially for those of us who live on our own. And so incorporating touch into our morning practice is really important. It's important for immunity, for well-being, it increases endorphins, our happiness hormones. And so I hope you enjoy it. And so the first move that we make is to warm the hands up. And give gratitude to the hands. So rather than rubbing them randomly or unconsciously, we add some mindfulness to that. So really tune in to the feeling of the sensation of one hand against the other. And when you have learned this routine, you can spend as much time as you like doing that. And just the attitude of being grateful has an effect on the nervous system. It switches it into parasympathetic or relaxation mode. And really tuning in like a scientist or an observer to the different sensations that the body is speaking back to you in. As if you're speaking to the body through this touch therapy, and the body is speaking back to you in sensations, and really diligently noticing to bring your attention in the differences between the sensations of one part of the body and another. I'll do this in sequence, but you can make up your own sequence. I'm going to the other elbow and then up to the shoulder. And once again, just to emphasize, this is a coaching video, so I'm perhaps not as mindful as I would normally be in my own practice, but you can really go in and feel the delicious sensations that you're creating, or even some discomfort and experience all that is. Stop for a moment and reflect on the sensations that you've created in your body. And then rub the hands together. Good to do that at heart level. Drop the attention down into the heart. Loving the hands. And then around the back of the neck, massaging as if you have two flannels in your hand. Warming all those muscles. Paying particular attention to the base of the skull at the back, where there's lots of what are called bony foramen, or holes in the bones where the nerves to the sense organs and of course the brain go through. And in Chinese medical terms, lots of acupressure points, again leading to the sense organs. A little bit of very gentle tapping over the skull and scalp. And tapping like this is a whole form in itself. And so if you enjoy this, this can be done again for a good length of time. The forehead, the cheekbones, the hinge of the jaw. Then rubbing the ears. And smoothing the forehead from the centre outwards, incorporating the eyebrows. And then shake out any tension that you may have built up in the shoulders from that short facial regime. And then just gently feel the sensations that you've created in your face, the body talking to you. A little bit of gentle tapping around the chest. So with loosely clenched fists, some tapping around the chest like this. The thymus gland and the big junctions of the lymph system are around this area. So stimulating the immune system, as well as contacting the upper regions of the lungs. And again, this can be done to loosen mucus, add to the health of the lungs. Down the centre and hands over the navel for a minute. Feel that warming sensation. And then circling around the navel, usually in the direction of the do digestive system. So up on the right, over the top, down the left, and then across and start again. Rub the hands together again. Take the hands around to the kidney area at the back. Give them a rub. Take loosely clenched fists to the sacral area and the tailbone and give that some attention. And then out to the glutes. And then to the top of the hips. And let's take that down the sides of the legs. Up the centre. Do this sitting if it's more comfortable for you, and also if it's not possible for you to bend over, please adapt, sit down and rotate the ankles or give yourself a gentle massage like this. Stopping for a moment, feeling the sensations in the legs, and then setting up some shaking. And so shake the hands as if you are trying to get raindrops or drops of water off the fingers. And go for that a little bit more vigorously than you normally would. Think about shaking your hands. And for a little bit of a longer time as well. And feel that in your wrists and feel it in your elbows. And feel it also in your shoulders now. And shaking might be the only thing that you do in this warm-up. It's incredibly good for switching the nervous system from sympathetic to parasympathetic. At least I find it is. It's a very primitive way of changing psychology, if you like. If you watch animals, they often shake after an encounter or after an activity. They get up and shake after sleeping and so on. It's a release. Let's go for some shaking of the legs now. Maybe just spend a moment feeling how that shaking has affected the sensations in your body. And now with the hands on the hips, shifting the weight over to one leg. And then if you are able to, lifting up the other foot and shaking the foot and the ankle. Again, as if you had water on the toes and you were trying to shift it off. Feeling it in the ankle, feeling it in the knee. And if you're not able to balance today, then just keep putting your foot down. I usually don't recommend holding something because when we do this and we do a balance pose, we are encouraging the mind and the body to come together so that we don't fall over. So it's a great way to get into the present. Hence my difficulty in explaining it. Okay, and then out to the sides. It's difficult to overthink when you're doing this. Once again, do it a little bit more beyond your comfort zone. Obviously, don't go into pain or too much discomfort, and please don't do anything that feels unsafe to you. And then put the weight down. And then shaking on the other side, the foot, the ankle, the knee. And sometimes I just do 10 minutes of this, or maybe sometimes even more, of shaking. It's a great warm-up. So that's a bit more difficult for me. The left foot is more difficult to balance on. Sometimes people hold as if they're holding two walls here, to use integral imaging. So you tell the body something through imagination and it responds sometimes. And out to the back. And then both feet down. And once again, just scan through the body and feel the effect of that. We'll do some smoothing. And so just smoothing the body like this, as if you're dusting off, feeling that sensation, giving the body a real sensory treat here. How does that feel? That dusting off. You could dust off around the kidneys, like so. Dust off down the legs. It's not particularly sunny today, but if you do this on a sunny day, imagine that you're opening yourself to let more sunshine in to your cells and to the spaces between the cells. You could run your fingers through your hair a little bit. The same intention. And again, this is again a form that you could do for 10 minutes, just the stroking and the dusting off, as it were, is something that you could do for a longer time. Another idea is to do a little bit of twisting around. So make sure that the top of your head is reaching towards the sky and your feet are deeply into the earth. And you're moving around the vertical of you. Make sure the knees are safe, that they're more or less pointing forward as you do this, so that they're not twisting awkwardly. Look behind you if you can to increase the rotation, but do keep your head pointing towards the sky so you get extension and rotation. You might hear that my hands are flopping against the sides of my body, waking up the liver and the kidneys. And bring that to a close. And again, do that for a longer time if it feels good. Let's do some tapping, and you can do this all the way over your body, or slapping, or patting is called, all the way over your body. But I'm just going to do it on the top of the shoulders, because often they're the areas that need it. And so what I've done is supported one elbow, palm up, cross the body, and use that as a massage tool. And if you move the elbow up and down, you'll find you can get right round to the top of the shoulder blade there. And forwards to the corner of the chest, the lung area, Chinese medicine. You could lean your head over and do a little bit of tapping, even fingertip tapping up the neck. And you can bring it then down the arm fairly firmly. Good one to do is to do shoulder to thumb. I usually follow that with a little bit of stroking. Cross over, support the elbow, tapping on the other side. All the time listening to the sensations in the body part that you're working on, and actually having a whole body awareness. So often when I'm tapping one part, I can feel sensations in another body part, the leg or the foot. So being very aware of that landscape of the body. And smoothing down the arm. And coming back to stand and once again reflecting on the sensations. This is also a lovely warm-up if you take your feet a little bit further apart. And we combine some things that we've already done. So top of the shoulder down to the hand, like so, but alternating arms. And then you might find that naturally you start to sway from one foot to the other. Keep the knees soft. Good warm up for the ankles, this, especially if you go into a little bit of a low, so you lower down like that, you'll find that that's a good warm up for the ankles, as well as a lovely opening for the upper body. Make it playful, as if you were on a child's swing or by the beach taking in the fresh air. And once again, do that for longer if it feels good. And then coming back to standing like a tree, the feet in the ground, top of the head towards the sky. Things that you might expect to happen is that slight moving of mucus in the upper lungs, the expelling of mucus, saliva also building up in your mouth is a good sign. And just take a moment to ground, to feel your ground, to feel the feet on the floor. Thank you for watching.